ananda kare vara bhaya kare saundarya ratna kare.
Any expedition requires serious preparation. In this ascent, we will be without any support for several weeks absolutely alone on the mountain. Therefore, we approached especially carefully to the selection of equipment, the purchase of products and even kitchen utensils. Now we are packing all our stuff, and you can see that Anton and me have really lots of stuff. A surprise was waiting for us at the airport. We weren't allowed to take frozen chicken with us on board the helicopter. Without any explanations and comments, just, no, it is banned. I had to dodge and involve sympathizers from among the airport staff into our criminal group. Disguise chicken as much as possible. Finally, the meat was taken through the secret airport lobbies. Republic of Nepal, Annapurna, 8,091 meters. It's the 10th highest mountain in the world. Annapurna is a female Sanskrit name translated as goddess of the harvests. It's a part of the massif in the Himalayas in north-central Nepal. The massif is 55 kilometers long, stretching from east to west. It was the first of the 8,000ers to be climbed. In 1950, the French expedition reached the summit. The mountain killer, great and terrible, the most dangerous 8,000er of the world. The mortality rate among climbers for all the years of climbing is 32%. Immediately after our successful ascent and ski descent from the mountain Manaslu in 2018, we decided to move on with the project and chose the most dangerous, terrible, and all in all, a really beautiful mountain Annapurna. The mountain that infuses fear, horror, and awe at the same time. Not half a year have passed and we have reached this place. Wonderful weather, a great pilot. It just took him half an hour to take us here, in this gorgeous place. And how long we have been waiting for that? Oh yeah, we've been waiting for ages. But will you show the people what is around us? Here it is, our goddess. There are no trifles in the big mountains, and all the equipment shouldn't just be fitted and tested, it should be in perfect condition. Therefore, before going out, we checked everything, from the drills and hooks to the video cameras and other equipment. Base camp, Annapurna here. We are waiting for the relevant weather, waiting for the forecast from you. It's been raining since morning today, pretty heavy. We decided to build a kitchen using our day of rest. Alex Abramov, thanks to the Club Seven Peaks for providing a tent for us. Actually, we don't use it quite as intended. We've used the ark and the awning. Can I warm myself up here for a while? Have a cup of tea. Cause I'm so much hungry that I have no place to stay overnight. Fried eggs are waiting for us here. And here, in the glacier, we have a shop. A butcher shop. Since we arrived for quite a long time, we stocked up with fresh meat. Frozen now, of course. Here, yesterday, we made a store, Today we want to complete it with a small piece. Here you are. Yesterday we put it here, and today completely unchanged. It is hard enough, Anton, isn't it? Yeah, it's a bit softer now. In a couple of days, we'll be back here, to the butcher shop. This is our canteen. We've built it today. Worked about 4 hours. Created our own way of life here. Now we're in quite comfortable conditions at the altitude of 4,000. Electricity, solar panels. Here we have soup, borscht. We're pouring cold water over the high-pressure bowl. It cools down. And now, look. That's it. The pressure dropped. Now look here. Just a moment. So delicious. And I also wanted to boast a little bit. Look, what a table we've made. What stony furniture we've got now. Well, how's that? Oh, so tasty. Frankly speaking, after a few days of work on the mountain, you begin to feel the need to take a shower and change clothes. It's not so realistic at high altitudes, but here, in the base camp, we use sunny days for washing and bathing. A healthy mind is not only in a healthy body, but also in a clean one. By the way, the mountain stream flows from the glacier, which is a kilometer above us, and flows along the rocks of the southern slope of the neighboring mountain. Therefore, the water warms up pretty well. What is real mountaineering, according to Mr. Pugovkin's system? To sleep, to stay in bed, for a day or two, or three. So, that's it. Let's get dressed and set off.
Drishya vibhuti vahana kari brahmanda bandodari leela nataka sutra kelana kari vidyana deepankuri shri vishwesh.
It's getting warmer. How are you? It's fine now. Since the sun has come out, life immediately has become good and fun. We have practically crossed the glacier, in fact, just a little bit left. This black rock formation. Right now, we'll see where we will go around them, on the right or on the left. We need to get to the top of them. We are looking for a road through the glacier. Actually, everything is not so difficult. The glacier is open. Today we've got a search of the way, from the first to the second camp. Go in light. In some places we can see the fixed ropes stretched to the height of 3 to 4 meters on the rock. It means ice used to be there. So, we're overcoming the snow bridges, while leaving this black rock section. Going to the second camp. Here we're entering the snow ramp. Crevasses everywhere, many crevasses. Well, guys, here's our first loss. This device, a stabilizer, is called Karma Grip, and it once worked, literally 3 minutes ago. While descending, I was rappelling using one hand, and it slipped away. It flew off the wall, falling for about 30 meters down, probably. I hoped so much to find it unbroken. But no way. Here we are, in the first camp again. It is very comfortable for us, because our accommodation is not on ice, not on snow, but on stones. And we have our own puddle, yes, drinking water from it, making tea. What are you doing? This is your flyer, Vitaly. Examination of the damage. Where is the beep coming from? It can be the camera, can it? I do not get it. Is it alive or what? Oh dear! This camera fell down from the height of 50 meters, fell on a rock and still alive? Damn it! Repair of stabilizer. What stabilizer are you talking about? I'm frying pancakes. And you are distracting me from an important matter. This little ring will be used to attach some weight there, which will pull the whole construction down. I had to use a file beforehand, so that the camera would walk more freely. Well, the camera can already be turned on. Here we will attach the weight to the wiring. Well, now let's see how it will shoot. So that's the way the backpack should be packed for such an expedition. The backpack is pretty huge, 65 liters, deuter. Plus 10 liters around it, not everything fits inside. Some stuff should be packed outside it, like that. They say that the burden of our own choice is not felt. No, it really does. So, GoPro, come here. You'll be living together with Sony. Yeah. Right here. Let's check the transceivers. Have you turned them on? We've calculated with Anton when the avalanche will start. The radius is 10 seconds. That's the time which takes the masses of ice to fly to the debris zone. It's clear that during this time you won't run far. It would seem that there are skis. You can get away pretty fast using them. But it's not so easy. You climb up using skis, and the descent on a small slope will be just a little faster than the ascent. We found a solution. We were looking for sucsess, rocky walls behind which it was possible to hide, and practiced sprint rushes in the debris zone. Well, we worked just two recent days on the mountain, but the feeling is that the psycho-emotional stress has reached its limit. Constant pressure, ice falls, avalanches, wind slaps where we were climbing all day long yesterday. We've covered probably 500 meters up, fixed all the ropes we had. We don't have any more, but we need to cover 300 more meters at least. Now we're going to think what can be done. Well, it's getting hard, very hard. A prehistoric man used a stone. Modern ski climber, a crampon instead of knife. And I wonder, what ski climbers use instead of toilet paper, huh? Climbing skins, perhaps? Vitaly, stop telling tales. Not bad at all. There were the cases when it was totally tasteless. We've just run here from over there, just sprinted for about 200 meters, at 5.8. And we've reached this secluded place, relatively safe. A cave has been found here. It's quite interesting, beautiful. Oh, Anton, let me make a video of myself in the reflection of your sunglasses. Hey, dude! Now we're getting ready to start our way up. Another key sector to pass. In camp 3, at 6.3, 6.27 to be more exact. Just a couple of minutes ago, we were shooting a video about our life here. For about 5 minutes probably, and then it turned out that I hadn't turned the camera on. These are the incidents which can occur at such altitude. Well, we'll repeat the experience. Yesterday we were climbing 600 meters all day long, about 9 hours or so. Why 9? Or how many? We came out at 8 a.m. At 9 p.m. I got back here. So 11 hours? 13. And then we were preparing the transport for 2 hours. Preparing for 2 hours. We fell asleep at midnight only. Well, something like that. In general, the mountain is very entertaining. The view from the window pleases. Though just a bit. Here we live, next door to the Kulva, where the avalanche is running non-stop. Some kind of shaman place here. The slope we were climbing is totally loaded. The Kulva below is attacked by avalanches in an unpredictable manner. Everything around is loaded. Yesterday we really didn't eat. Just heated some water. We ate some fried water, then some steamed water, and went to bed. The place of our camp, Camp 3, such as a miniature ground. And over there, you can see the exit, the ridge where we're not going today. There is still long distance to the exit, but today we're not going up, we're going down. So beautiful. Are you cold? Anton. Well, it seems like without a downy mitten, it's really cold. And by the way, it's 6.3. It is chilly. I wish we could be there now, yeah? And over there, there are ice trains, going one by one. According to the schedule, or without any schedule, avalanches run all over, all fucking over. On the left, on the right, wherever. Oh my god. The remains of fixed ropes. Obviously, from the previous ancient expeditions. We're going to have a sprint now. For 200-300 meters. Another one. But now, at least there will be a sprint down. A bit simpler. What is there? One more avalanche went down. Oh yeah. Such a hit on the head from above. And it will be enough. You're standing here, I'm going under the Sarek. You're watching me there. We've got an island of security, just there, only there. Look, there is something interesting on the Serac, as if someone's footprints are there. But these were stones rolling. Yeah, just stones. We are the only humanoids here. Me and Anton. Freedom! Here it is, the zone of death on Annapurna. Not only above 8,000, it is a whole zone of death. It looks like hell, the place we've just been to. Having just gone down. This is the nastiest place. Virtually 2 minutes later, the avalanche came down. It is free! The avalanche is running! The snow, though damp, was rather good for such skiing. I was going down with a very heavy backpack. Such altitude, the lack of oxygen, 30 kilos over the shoulders, I had to stop every 50-70 meters. But it was very encouraging fact that for the hundreds of square kilometers, this ski trail is the only one. It is hard to ski at such altitude with such a backpack. Fuck. It took me the whole year to prepare for this expedition to not reach the summit. Still can't believe it. There is still some hope. Some hope, but I want to live. Just don't want to die. That's it. It's dangerous, very dangerous. Actually, today I think we need to drink tea. Or to drink something, you know, hotter. To celebrate the fact that we're coming back home safe and sound. Refusing further climbing is a difficult but correct decision. It's hard to believe in that. Throughout the year, you live with the thought of the upcoming ascent, thinking over each and every detail, falling asleep with the thoughts of the expedition, waking up with the thoughts of the mountain. The head is fully engaged in establishing some kind of connection, a connection between you and the mountain. Moreover, you begin to perceive it not as a mass of ice, snow and rocks, but as a living organism. Sometimes it even seems like a little bit going crazy. The decision has been made, and you understand this necessity in your mind, but the heart is breaking, jumping outside, and it takes time to accept this fact in order to be able to leave the mountain without bitterness, to leave it in order to leave. It took me 3 days to talk with myself. That's what Zen is. It enables you to thank the mountain, acknowledge the end of the expedition, and to start making plans and live for future. Today we're packing the baggage and going down. That's the situation. We can't afford to fly away by helicopter, it's too expensive, so we're going to get away on foot. Waiting for the porters to come is too long, it can take a few days. So we made a decision to pack all the things in big bales and to carry everything down by ourselves. These are the backpacks we've packed. Each of them is 60 kilos, not less. From time to time, we plot the coordinates, sending them to Moscow to find out where we are, to localize ourselves on the map, and to understand how far from the nearest settlement we are. And we should go there. Over there. That is how our hopes to take a bath today were destroyed. We were told there is no bridge, yet ready to swim. As you see, the water is really clean. The places are surely fabulous. Frankly, in Nepal, I've never seen such beautiful nature before. We've been going through the windbreak for the second hour, I think. The trail is so poorly visible. What's the difference? It's a path. Look what is growing here. Who could call it a trail? It's some kind of an Indian path. Nepalese Indians. In some places it can be barely seen. Sometimes it disappears, though it can be detected in some way. In general, it's real to move on. We've probably been going through the forest zone for an hour, so it has no end. This is not a trail. It's fucked up. I've never walked along such trails. Never ever. Hallelujah! Fuck! Guys, it's a fucking disaster! Good trail. Whoa, some stairs have appeared. Very human steps. To be honest, it's a real joy. Are we indeed approaching civilization? Here is one more glimpse of joy. The bridge. That's a real miracle! We can see a bridge, quite a civilized bridge. So, somewhat like, well, maximum 3 days of trekking and there is a chance to meet people. I'd like to get there by lunchtime!
Выходим. Пипец. Смотрите, они там живые.
В палатках люди.
Гомо сапиенс. Наконец-то.
3 недели не видели.